Everybody get up. White trash, medulla oblongata, vulva, and anti-disestablishmentarianism. God damn it. All right. DJ, are you ready for that beat?
Word.
Because I'm not. So anyway, let's kick this shit. Yeah. Oh, shit. I run this shit like it's a pond and I'm a hippopotamus. Girl, you know, at the end of the day, I'm with ya. No, I'm not a victim of affluenza. Every now and then, with me, you'll have a blast. Take you back to the trailer, cause you know I'm white trash. And we're gonna have fun, get the job done. And you know, girl, when it comes to those titties, I wanna. I'm gonna get stuck in your brain, your medulla oblongata. On your vulva. And you know, we came to have fun tonight. It's alright, have a shot and it's so tight. And every now and then I get caught up in your mind like a motherfucking schizo, huh? Cause I preach a gospel of anti-disestablishmentarianism. Yeah! I did what a guy that looks like me should never do, and that is, you know, fresh out of the shower, I caught a full-length mirror view of myself, and I was like, oh shit, I'm a marshmallow with nipples. And that was after I manscaped, you know what I mean? There's no way I would get a chick being a hairy marshmallow with nipples, so. And I'm short, too. It bothers me. It's tough that I'm short, man, but I can put up with a lot of the names, you know, short stack, little guy, short Mike, you know what I mean, little pistol starter, you know what I mean, little heat giver, you know, I'm down, right? But whatever you do, don't call me a midget, all right? Midget is so offensive, it's offensive to midgets, all right? True story, I was hanging out with my little midget friend the other day, right? We were kicking it, and I was like, yo, midget, and he's like, don't call me midget, man, that's offensive. That's like saying the N-word to black people. And I was like, midget, please. And then he got all mad. He was like, no, man, I'm gonna fucking fight you. I'm gonna call my boys. I'm gonna fuck you up. And I was like, whoa, you my midget? You my midget? Midget five? Midget five? So, yeah, no, we ended up getting along so good, man. We got in the car and we were cruising and we were listening to like some DMX tunes. And, you know, he was feeling it. He was like, you know, midgets wanna try. Midgets wanna die. Midgets is the life. Midgets do or die. I was like, yeah. They were listening to the Dre, and he was like, you don't really want to fuck with me. Only midget that I trust is me. I was like, yeah. So, hanging out with the midget, so. So yeah, not only am I short, but I'm delusional, I think. I went on a blind date recently with a girl, and I thought it was going really well. She, you know, seemed to really connect with me online. Went to her house, opened the door, knocked on the door. No, we had a connection, right? So I knocked on her door. She opened it and she looked really disappointed. And I was like, what's wrong, girl? And she was like, well, you said on your profile your body was like a trophy. And I said, no, darling, my body is atrophied, all right? I give it up. This is body by PlayStation and Bong, all right? This is, I'm committed, so. It was tough, though. So, no, it hurt me because she didn't call me back, you know? I tried to text her, tried to call her, tried to Facebook her. She didn't get back to me. And I didn't want to come off too stalkery because, you know, guys, you don't want to be weird like that. So really sad she never got back to me because now I have to kill her cat. Sure, I could kill any old cat, but I want her to know it's real love, you know? And you can only masturbate outside of a woman's window before you're like, she's not taking our love seriously. It's a joke. Unless you saw me, and then I'm sorry. The shades. I don't know how to express love. Anyway, she let me on though, guys. She did. She looked deep in my eyes, And she said, yes, Your Honor, that's the man that killed my cat that's been masturbating outside of my... I'm like, oh, I thought we had real love. So, yeah. But anyway, it was a lot of fun. I actually, you know, I've had such bad luck with women. A good friend of mine was like, dude, you might be gay. And I was like, I'm not gay. And he was like, bro, what if you're gay? I'm like, I'm not gay. And he was like, dude, you might be gay. And I was like, Clint Ballsy, stop hoping I'm gay. But anyway, I was mad, so I just blew him off, you know? And that, wait, I mean, wrong choice of words, so. I ignored him. But I realized, though, that, you know, every straight dude has, you know, their gay side, and it's okay, you should embrace it, you know? Like, for instance, the other day I was going home, and I heard that song by Katy Perry, Lion. I am a lion, roar, roar, roar. You know what I'm talking about, right? So, anyway, I heard that song, and I was like, nah, that's not for me. That's, you know, I'm a hardcore straight dude. That's Metallica. I was like, hey, hey, and driving home. But then later that night, I heard Rachel sing it on Glee, and I was like, oh my God, I am a lion. I am gonna roar. So, that's a chubby kid dancing. You can't unsee that.
There now follows just a few short samples of the things to come from entertainment and media.